Hello everybody, this is Danuzi. Let's continue the adventure in Andromeda. I'm not gonna comment on the rest of the video because my voice is terrible of this bad cold I have. Enjoy the video, guys!
I'll make it right, Dash.
Feeling a little better.
I promise.
Looks like the muscle is pulling out.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks and looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Yeah. Let's go see the rest of Heleus.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Thank goodness. For a sec, I thought I was gonna have to deal with Addison again.
And no one wants that. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Everything's state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
Every plan the Initiative made is out the window. Now it's on us to find the way.
We all came here ready for a challenge. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
The meeting room. You can make vid calls from the central table or just get the crew together. We call this the research room. You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions. You must be Ryder, Galojath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Heleus.
I'm new to this. Being a Pathfinder running a ship?
You'll be fine. As for the ship, I can help. I knew the Tempest when she was a blueprint. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big? I guess we have to be.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
Helm is green. Gil reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours. Unless you've got something to say for the log.
I never planned to be Pathfinder. I don't know what's out there. But we're the Milky Way's best and brightest. We can do this.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
To EOS, then. What would have been our Habitat 1?
Two field outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Callow, take us in.
As far as the Nexus surveyors could get before, well...
Let's see what's waiting here. I'm picking up something. Something. anomaly detected. Up something. Anomaly on sensors. Anomaly detected. Anomaly on sensors.
System, Heleus. Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated EOS.
It was supposed to be an easy first step. Until no one else showed and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of EOS. A mirror of the signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the cat.
Anomaly detected.
Up.
Ready, Freddy.
Hope we're all that ready. Callow, all right?
Integrating search area from Sam. How he pulled that mystery signal through the storms, I have no idea.
Multisensory neural collision. Amazing.
Factory fresh across the board. Spinning up the compensators.
You're already tuning the displays.
We'll get a better read on this pass than the Nexus has had in months.
People have their hopes pinned on us. They gave up on Eos. Can't blame them. Expected a golden world, instead they saw their friends die. Never know how that'll affect.
Sorry. You okay?
I think I'm still messed up by what happened with my dad.
There hasn't been much time to process it.
No. I mean, I think I'm still feeling it. Like, hearing things, other than Sam.
Pathfinder, the Tempest checks out. We're good.
Take us down.
You have no idea how long I've wanted a Pathfinder to say that.
Core is hot.
Shields holding, adjusting entry.
We got this, right? Set us down at this nav point. How to even start?
Reports state this planet suffers deadly storms that are contaminated by radiation from the Scourge. EO's deployment was incomplete due to environmental hazards and ultimately hostile encounters.
Plus, no Pathfinder. If EOS is like Habitat 7, that signal we scanned must be connected with the atmosphere. We could use the outpost's antenna to track it down. Let's get the power back on. They must have known these wouldn't last in these conditions.
They didn't have a Pathfinder.
They do now. We'll make EOS a home. Door's getting emergency power, but it's code locked.
Site 1 issued individual security codes. Each outpost self-organizes and sets its own protocol.
Just say we can't open it without codes.
We can't open it without codes. Inoperable, Pathfinder.
Too long in this environment without power.
We didn't expect this kind of environment. Who could?
Suffered our first death today. It's storm came out of nowhere. Lockley tried to cover our crops. Lost his footing. Got swept away. His wife is still in cryo. Maybe by the time they wake her up, I'll know what to say.
Got a code lock key.
That should help get us in.
Main door had power, but not the interior doors?
Full functionality would require an active power relay station.
That means the antenna's out of power, too. The logs might tell us what's up with the power relay. I got a partial log, but I can't turn on the antenna. Something's blocking the power.
A remote lock is active. The interference originates from a nearby power relay tower.
So we're not the only ones interested in what happened here.
Let's check out this relay tower. Look at this place. It's a wasteland.
The radiation in Eos's atmosphere makes it difficult to cultivate life.
Radiation? Our suits protect against that, right?
Site 1 contains shield masts to dampen the brunt of contamination.
But if we went outside Site 1...
Structure up ahead. Sam?
It fits the profile of a power relay station, Pathfinder.
Right. We get it running, maybe buildings get power.
And we get a line on that signal.
This analysis provides... Pathfinder, that door is locked. Until power is restored, there is no way to unlock it or gain entry to these buildings.
That ship wasn't Ket, then. They don't knock.
There are people here? We thought everyone left was gone.
Of course you did. Now shove off. Find your own salvage. This spot's taken.
I'm not a salvager. I'm a Pathfinder. We've come to fix all this.
Call me Clancy. Pathfinder, huh? Like that changes much. The Nexus just can't let Eos go, can it? However much it fails down here.
I'm tracking a signal that will help Eos. I only need power for the antenna.
Look, I cut the power for a reason. The Ket are patrolling today. You turn the power relay back on, they'll know there's a juicy target alive down here.
Is it smarter to hide and hope, or take a chance that might save this whole planet?
I remember when people used to talk like that. Okay, I'll enable the generators out there. You want to poke the tiger, it's on you.
Expect trouble when we start the generators.
There's an error in the startup sequence. Manual input required.
Damn it.
Please scan one of the pylons to determine a hackable input location. Generator interface possible. Location marked.
Generator is active. Sam, our friend Clancy, was he part of the outpost team here?
No, Pathfinder. According to Nexus records, he's stationed in the hangar bay.
So he's what? Playing hooky?
Or he's a part-time salvager.
Company.
You took down all those cat? Sure, use the power relay. Hell, take whatever you like. Word of advice, though. If that signal of yours is out past the perimeter, you'll need a ride.
A ride?
Shuttles aren't fun in these winds. You need wheels. I think they kept a little something in storage.
Didn't get around to salvaging it yet?
I tried. It ain't that simple. Might be easier for a Pathfinder, though. We're heading to our shuttle. Keep this up. Maybe next time we'll find more than just salvage around here.
Go on. We'll take it from here.
I guess Crazy Blue has to buy her parts from someone else.
Power restored. We should have access to everything in Site 1 now, right, Sam?
Correct. Plus, I've located the source of the signal we detected in orbit. It's coming from the large alien structure just beyond Site 1. The structure appears almost identical to the one your father used to adjust the atmosphere on the previous planet. It's worth investigation.
That almost feels like a lead. Damn right it's worth investigating.
Hehe.
A warning. Radiation levels beyond the perimeter of Site 1 are well above acceptable limits. You cannot proceed without additional protection.
All the more reason to see if that alien structure can make a difference to this planet. Come on, we better find that vehicle Clancy mentioned.
Now the power is restored, we can investigate the nearby buildings.
Well, what do you know? The outpost's research center is still intact.
Updating the Tempest on this critical recovery.
Research was always key to the initiative. We'll need it here, too.
This tech is how we survive in Andromeda. Ingenuity on the ground.
Someone else agrees. This research center was used recently to monitor the alien signal.
This gives us the tools to find the source, and maybe whoever else is looking.
Research station is back online. I've provided a list of weapons we can build by gathering the required components.
If you enjoyed this video, like always, hit the like button, leave a comment if you want me to continue this beautiful game. And if you want to help me to grow this channel to a bigger one, subscribe for more videos. See you on the next one.